not help his cause. Okendo was unbeaten, but he was unrated. He knocked down ATN a total of 7 times.
Watch his last knockdown. He's working on the ropes, and the right hand is landing. There you see the stagger, and there you see the finisher. Incredible susceptibility on the right, whole left side with the by the right hand. ATN just showing no way to defend against right hands that come around. I mean, he just doesn't even pick his left hand up, Steve. I'm shocked.
He was totally fatigued and exhausted. Couldn't do it. Down he goes for a 7th and final time. What a big blow to the highly regarded Clifford ATN, who was perhaps still feeling the effects of his war with Lawrence Claybe. Let's get the official numbers from Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1 minute 37 seconds in round number 8. A referee in charge, Jay Nady, stops the contest upon advice of the corner. The winner by way of technical knockout. He is still undefeated, the Big O, Fres Okendo.
So Fres Okendo pulls off the upset. He moves to 20-0 with 11 knockouts. Meanwhile, Clifford ATN suffers his first career loss and slips to 19-1. Fres Okendo, on the shoulders of 7 knockdowns, surprising previously undefeated Clifford ATN. Coming up next, our main event for the big men, number 5 IBF heavyweight contender, David Tua, goes against the number 3 IBF-rated Donnell Nicholson, with the winner emerging as number 1. Into the dressing room of the always affable, easygoing David Tua, born on a tiny island in West Samoa, now living in South Auckland, New Zealand, has totally revamped his training regimen and mode of preparation since the embarrassing loss to Lennox Lewis. Manager Kevin Barry, new trainer Joe Goosen. You see Joe right there on the left, brought in a strength coach, a dietitian to get his weight down and add even more lean muscle mass. But his weight is actually up from the Lewis fight, somewhat surprising. Historically, he has had difficulty with boxers, and Nicholson falls into that category. But he is heavily favored to bounce back tonight. Set for post-fight reaction, let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Steve, as the two continue to exchange words here. Clifford, let me ask you first. You were heavily favored in this fight. You went down 7 times, 3 times in the first round. What happened?
He caught me. I still got a little right there on the back of my head. Might be able to see it on the ball. But, I mean, it was good shots. He hit me.
Did he catch you all 3 of those knockdowns in the first round? Were they all clean?
I think the first one was, he kind of pushed me with his elbow. But, I mean, he caught me on the back of my head. But that wasn't nothing, man. The other two, that was a good knockdown. That was legit. So I got to tip my hat to him. And I'm a sportsman. He was a better man tonight.
Are you surprised by his performance?
Yeah, because he was more elusive than I thought. It wasn't just the foot speed, because I knew he was moving. It was a leaning back. You know what I'm saying? Because if I could catch you if you're just moving. But when I throw and you lean back, that gives you another 5 inches, 6 inches. So. You know, he did good. I'm glad. I want him to handle his business, too. He's young, you know. I want everybody to buy enough money for all of us, man.
Yeah, baby.
You know what I'm saying?
All right, Clifford Fres, let's ask you. What realistically did you expect coming into this fight tonight? You were a big, big underdog and virtually unheard of.
Yeah, first of all, I want to... Les quiero hacer mandarlo a Ramón Montonini, Río Piedra, mi tití Michael, primo Michael, Anedelia, Tito, todo el mundo que me veo golo.
Translate for us as you go along. We have a lot of English-speaking people, too, as well.
Yeah, I'm showing out representation where I was born. San Juan, Puerto Rico, Río Piedra, Ramos, Ramón Montonini, the projects, el caserío, where I was from. Toda mi gente de caserío, te amo y vamos a venir con gloria.
All right, now to the question. What did you expect? A lot of people haven't heard of you until tonight. Virtually unheard of for you to pull off a performance like this.
Like I told everybody, first of all, I want to thank Showtime for giving me this opportunity. Dan Goosen, number one promoter in the world. He tops Don King with this one. But anyway, I always had confidence in myself. Since my 10 pro fight, when Dan and Tom put me in there with Duncan Duck Worry, another dangerous guy was 14-0. And another one, Don Felly, the genius. He made me what I am today. The last fight, I wasn't even nothing like I am today. It's all natural. This man got the greatest champions, Tito Fres Okendo.
You knocked him down 6 times. and you weren't able to put him away? Were you starting to think in your mind, uh-oh, I might be caught by a shot and I could lose this fight even though I've dominated?
Like Don Felix said in the press conference, everybody don't be surprised. If I don't knock him out, I'm prepared to go 10 rounds.
What's next for you?
Well, we got to sit down. The G Papa Don Felix and Dan Goose of American Presents. People always had confidence since I turned pro. Out of all the heavyweight they had, Pyle Wolfgang, Clay Bialdo, I was the least to make it where I am today. And thank God he gave me the opportunity. And I love that man for this. I'm not poor no more.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, American Presents. I love
all
you.
All right, let's go back over to you, Steve.
Thank you, Jim. Nice guy, Frez Okendo, humbles Clifford ATN. At it this way, Dave Moretti, 68-61. Darby Shirley, 68-60 for Okendo, and Glenn Trowbridge, 68-60. I noticed a sprinkling of 10-6 here.
You know, I see, Steve, on the scorecard, a few of the fighters, judges scored that first round 10-6. I had it 10-7, and I still had it 68-60.